Welcome you all to this session, children. In the last session, we have seen about molar mass, mole concept, empirical and molecular formula calculation. In today's session, we will be seeing about stoichiometric calculation, meaning of limiting reagent, and how to express the concentration of the solution, that is in terms of molarity, molality, mole fraction and mass percentage. Stoichiometry is very important in understanding chemical reactions. What is meant by stoichiometry? Stoichiometry deals with the calculation of masses of the reactant and product involved in a reaction, because whenever we write an equation, we should know the amount of reactants and product that are taking part in the reaction. For the reaction of methane, let us take the example, methane reacts with oxygen. So we have to write the balance equation for this. CH4 plus 2O2 gives carbon dioxide plus 2H2O. Methane is reacting with water in the gaseous state. Methane gas plus oxygen gas gives carbon dioxide gas plus water in the gaseous state. The coefficient 2 for water and oxygen are called stoichiometric coefficient. So after balancing the equation is CH4 plus 2O2 gives CO2 plus 2H2O. The coefficient 2 for water and oxygen are called stoichiometric coefficient. The coefficient for methane and carbon dioxide is 1 in each case. They represent the number of molecules taking part in the reaction. So according to the above chemical reaction, 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen to give 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. What we learn from this balanced chemical equation? What inferences we draw? Let us draw the following conclusion from the above equation. That is, 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen to give 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. Or we can say 1 molecule of methane reacts with 2 molecules of oxygen to give 1 molecule of carbon dioxide and 2 molecules of water. If we are going to express in terms of volume, 1 mole of any gas at STP as a volume of 22.7 liters. So in terms of volume, we can tell 22.7 liter of methane reacts with 45.4 liter of oxygen to give 22.7 liter of carbon dioxide and 45.4 liter of water. If we are going to express in terms of mass, the molar mass of methane is 16. So if you are going to express in terms of mass, we can say 16 gram of methane reacts with 2 into 32 gram of oxygen to give 44 gram of carbon dioxide and 36 gram of water. After learning about stoichiometric coefficient, let us learn the term limiting reagent. So from the term itself, we are able to understand that limiting, which limits the progress of a reaction. So many a times the reactions are carried out when the reactants are not present in the amount as required by a balanced chemical reaction. In such situation, one reactant is excess over the other. So what happens? One of the reactant may be excess. So the reactant which is present in the lesser amount get consumed after some time, and after that no further reaction takes place, whatever may be the amount of the other reactant. So for a reaction to proceed, both the reactants are necessary to be present in the required amount. If one of the reactant gets over in the middle, then the reaction will not proceed. So the reactant which get consumed limits the amount of product formed and is called the limiting reagent. I will explain the concept to you with the help of an example. In the reaction, 2A plus 4B giving 3C plus 4D. 2A plus 4B giving 3C plus 4D. When 5 moles of A react with 6 moles of B. 5 moles of A reacts with 6 moles of B. Then which is the limiting reagent? In this reaction, you have to find out which is the limiting reagent. Also, calculate the amount of C formed. So, let us see now. According to the equation, 2 moles of A will react with 4 moles of B. So, in the problem, it is given 6 moles of B. So, 5 moles of A will react with 10 moles of B, but B available is only 6 moles. If A is 5 moles, then it needs 10 moles of B according to the equation. But B available is only 6 moles. So, 5 moles of A will need 10 moles of B, but B available is only 6 moles. So, B is the limiting reagent. I hope you are able to understand. B is the limiting reagent in this reaction. Amount of C formed. Next question is, what is the amount of C formed? So, with the available quantity of B, how much of C is formed? Amount of C formed will be calculated as follows. Amount of C formed will depend upon the limiting reagent. According to the equation, 4 moles of B forms 3 moles of C. So, 6 moles of B, because only 6 moles of B is available, so how much of C will be formed? 6 moles of B will form 3 by 4 into 6, that is 4.5 moles. 4.5 moles of C will be formed after the reaction. Expression of concentration of a solution. We are dealing with so many solutions in the lab, and in analytical chemistry we have to find out the concentration of the solution. The term is very important. So concentration can be expressed in terms of mass percentage, mole fraction, molarity and molality. Mass percentage, mole fraction, molarity and molality. So what is mass percentage? Mass percentage or weight percentage is defined as the mass of the solute by mass of the solution into 100. Mass percentage is equal to mass of the solute by mass of the solution into 100. Let us take an example. A solution is prepared by adding 2 gram of a substance A to 18 gram of water. Calculate the mass percentage of the solute. A solution is prepared by adding 2 gram of a substance A to 18 gram of water. Calculate the mass percentage of the solution. So, mass percentage of A is equal to mass of A by mass of the solution into 100. That is 2 by 2 plus 18. Mass of the solution is solute plus solvent, 2 plus 18. So, 2 by 2 plus 18 into 100. That is equal to 2 by 20 into 100, which is equal to 10%. Mole fraction. Mole fraction is defined as the ratio of the number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of the solution. Number of moles of a particular component to the total number of moles of the solution. For example, if a solution A dissolves in solution B, and the number of moles of A and B are Na and Nb, small Na plus Nb respectively. Then the mole fraction of A and B will be given as mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A by number of moles of the solution. That is equal to Na by Na plus Nb. Mole fraction of B will be given by number of moles of B by number of moles of the solution. That is equal to Nb by Na plus Nb. Next, molarity. Molarity denoted by capital M, it is defined as the number of moles of the solute in 1 liter of the solution. Molarity is defined as the number of moles of the solute in 1 liter of the solution. So, molarity is equal to number of moles of the solute by volume of the solution in liter. For example, calculate the molarity of sodium hydroxide in the given solution prepared by dissolving its 4 gram in enough water to form 250 ml of the solution. So, molarity is equal to number of moles of the solute by volume of the solution in liter. But what is number of moles? Number of moles is equal to given mass by molar mass. So, here given 4 gram mass is given as sodium hydroxide mass, and molar mass of sodium hydroxide is 23 plus 16 plus 1, that is equal to 40 gram. So, number of moles of sodium hydroxide is equal to given mass by molar mass, that is 4 by 40 is equal to 0.1 moles. Molarity is equal to number of moles by volume in liter. So, it is given 250 ml, which is equal to 0.250 liter. So, molarity is equal to 0.1 by 0.250, which is equal to 0.4 mole per liter. Or you can write 0.4 capital M, that is molarity, 0.4 m. Next term is molality. Molality is defined as the number of moles of the solute present in 1 kilogram of the solvent. Molality is defined as the number of moles of the solute present in 1 kilogram of the solvent. So, molality is equal to number of moles of the solute by mass of the solvent in kilogram. Number of moles of the solute by mass of the solvent in kilogram, and it is expressed with the letter small m. So far we have learned about stoichiometric calculation, limiting reagent and expression of concentration of the solution. Hope you would have understood these concepts. So in the next class, in the next video, we will be going for the next chapter. Thank you, children.